Researchers will leave sensors in the opening to better comprehend the long-haul changes in the ice, which may have huge ramifications for worldwide ocean level. Researchers have looked into one of the minimum investigated swaths of sea on Earth, a huge locale situated off the shore of West Antarctica. It is bolted underneath an outside of ice bigger than Spain and in excess of 1,000 feet thick, making its water ceaselessly dull, and to a great degree troublesome for people to get to. Presently, a group of specialists has drilled an opening through the ice and inspected the sea underneath it. Their work could reveal insight into an ineffectively small, yet foreboding scene in Antarctica's current past. A group of researchers from New Zealand started this two-month campaign in November. A ski-mounted twin otter flying machine carried them 220 miles from the closest base, arriving close to the center of the Ross Ice Shelf, the monstrous section of ice and snow, as level and void as a prairie, that hangs off the coastline of West Antarctica and buoys on the sea. In the midst of the gleam of 24-hour summer daylight sifting down through haze, they gathered a car-estimated contraption of funnels, hoses, and boilers. See a greater amount of the world beneath Antarctic ice. This machine created an intense fly of heated water, which they used to soften two restricted openings, each a couple of crawls over, in excess of 1,100 feet down to the base of the ice. They at that point brought down cameras and different instruments through the gaps, into the waters beneath. In doing as such, they would have liked to answer an issue of overall significance: exactly how secure is the ice of West Antarctica? The West Antarctic ice sheet is up to 10,000 feet thick in a few spots. It sits in a wide, low bowl that plunges a huge number of feet underneath ocean level, making it defenseless against profound, warm sea streams that are as of now nipping at its external edges. It is settled, in any event for the present, by a phalanx of skimming ice retires, that hang off its external edges, of which the Ross Ice Shelf is by a wide margin the biggest. Those skimming racks give a brace, they are keeping down a major measure of ice, says Craig Stevens, an oceanographer from the National Institute of Water and Atmospheric Research in New Zealand, who took an interest in the campaign. Worldwide ocean levels would ascend by 10 feet if West Antarctica lost these significant stabilizers and spilled its ice into the sea. Researchers expect that some of these ice racks are as of now debilitating. Stevens and his associates wanted to survey the soundness of the Ross Ice Shelf by estimating water temperatures and sea streams underneath it, in this way deciding how rapidly ice is softening off its underside. Astounding finds. The astonishment started nearly when a camera was brought down into the primary borehole, around December 1st. The undersides of ice racks are normally smooth because of slow softening. However, as the camera went through the base of the gap, it demonstrated the underside of the ice embellished with a sparkling layer of level ice gems, like a disorder of snowflakes, prove that in this specific place, ocean water is really frigid onto the base of the ice as opposed to dissolving it. "It knocked our socks off," says Christina Helby, a glaciologist from the University of Otago in New Zealand, who co-drove the endeavor. The Ross Ice Shelf is viewed as more steady, at show, than a significant number of West Antarctica's other skimming racks, and this perception could help clarify that, if a couple of creeps of ocean water occasionally solidifies onto the base of its ice, this could support it from diminishing all the more quickly. The new gaps bored through the Ross Ice Shelf additionally give a more broad window into the obscure. Under the ice rack is an immense measure of sea, it's the volume of the North Sea amongst England and Norway, says Holby, and there are no estimations there. Just twice before have people punctured the profound inside of the Ross Ice Shelf to think about its basic sea. In 1977, specialists penetrated through the ice rack 300 miles in from its offshore edge, around 80 miles inland from the momentum openings, and in 2015 a group bored through the back corner of the ice rack, 500 miles in from its toward the ocean edge. Those investigations gave just short looks of how profound, warm water circles under the ice rack, covering a couple of hours or days. Looking to the future. This time around, the New Zealand group introduced instruments in one of their openings that will screen sea streams and water temperatures under the ice for the following 2 years or thereabouts, radiating that data home by means of satellite connection. It's essential to comprehend these streams, says Stevens, in light of the fact that on the off chance that we get the course wrong, at that point we're getting the softening incorrectly. The new venture could likewise cast light on some waiting doubts, that despite the fact that the Ross Ice Shelf appears to be steady today, it has really experienced some sensational falls in the current past. Find out about the main estimate opening in Antarctica. Reed Shearer made this revelation in 1998 while contemplating mud that had been culled from underneath the West Antarctic ice sheet, through another borehole, 100 miles inland from the back edge of the ice rack. Shearer, a miniaturized scale scientist now at Northern Illinois University in DeKalb, discovered this subglacial mud chock-a-block brimming with minuscule diatom shells, excellent lustrous items, reminiscent of fine vases. They were the old stays of photosynthetic living beings that had once lived in the ocean before biting the dust and settling to the base. Some of those dead diatoms were just a couple of hundred thousand years of age, driving Shearer to an amazing conclusion: this region, now secured by 3,000 feet of ice, had as of late been untamed ocean, washed in life-maintaining daylight that could bolster the diatom's development. This proposed the whole Ross Ice Shelf, and a great part of the ice behind it, had fell. The Ross Ice Shelf has gone back and forth likely ordinarily over the most recent million years, says Shearer. It likely fallen amid a warm period 400,000 years prior. In any case, he trusts it could likewise have fell as of late as 120,000 years back, the last time that temperatures were about as warm as they are today. The New Zealander's venture could reveal insight into this inquiry. One day in December, a barrel dribbling with dim sparkling mud was raised out of the borehole, into the splendid summer sun, a center cold from the ocean bottom, 2,400 feet underneath the bore site. As the researchers break down that mud, it might yield more diatoms. Also, that could give another opportunity to explore when this region was free of ice before, says Shearer. I'm extremely intrigued to perceive what the Kiwis find.